Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Today I'm gonna do a photo edit and I'm gonna do it outside. I wanna make something different than what you guys usually see, so I'm in the park. Now I wanted to do this whole thing in my home behind my computer, you know, with the light and on the kind of studio setup, but there's just so many distractions, and if you have a family, you know, the kids running around, you know, the missus is not keeping quiet, the television is running. So I've decided I'm gonna come here to the park and do a photo edit. And this is a photo I took 2 weeks ago. This is a photo of Lake Bled. It was when I was going home, I looked around and I saw this castle at the right position, and I immediately thought, I'm gonna do this golden spiral composition. And the sun was already setting behind the hill, so it was blue hour, but the sky was really bright and the foreground and everything was really in the shadow. So that's like a killer combination for my Lumix G9 and the Micro Four Thirds camera with 12 stops of dynamic range. So I had to underexpose the shot quite a lot. I also made the shot handheld, which you can see it's kind of bent, but we'll correct that, and I'll place the main subject, that castle, into the eye of the spiral. So the golden spiral comes out of the Fibonacci sequence of numbers, and that's basically by adding the number before to the number you have, you get the next number. Let me explain. If you start with the number 1 and then you add 0, you get another 1, and then you add this one to that one, you get number 2, and then you add the one here to number 2, you get number 3, and then to 3 you add the number before, which was number 2, you get number 5, and then 8, and then 13, and then 21, and you know, it just goes on. And if you put this on a two-dimensional plane, you draw it in squares with these ratios, you can actually make a spiral shape. Now I don't know what's with this spiral shape. I think it's because it's all in nature and we find spirals everywhere, but it just feels right if you have the main focus point or the main focus subject in your frame in the eye of the spiral. This is why I want to put that castle right in the smack down middle of that spiral eye. Okay, so first of all, we need to balance the image out. We need to bring back the highlights and the shadows. Now I've underexposed the shot to capture all of the details in the sky, and therefore all the shadows are really dark, and I need to bring back the shadows and tone down the highlights to kind of just decontrast the image. So this will be the first step, and I will do this in Photoshop in the camera raw filter, which is basically Lightroom within Photoshop. Then the second thing is the most important thing, is going to be cropping the image in. I've taken this image a little bit wider so that I can have a little bit of a maneuvering space to crop the image in, and I want to place that castle right in the eye of the sphere. This is going to give me that kind of natural organic balance in what is otherwise a very unbalanced image. Now I could put the horizon, the virtual horizon, in the middle of the frame, so dividing the frame top to bottom, but it just doesn't look really good. I have so much dead space in front, and I really then have the subject really too high. So I want to have that castle, which is the main element, in the eye of the spiral, and that's going to be the main focus point of the whole shot. Now there's an island on the lake which is really dark, so we're gonna have to bring this up just as well. I'm gonna show you a trick how you can really make something pop out in a very shadowy area. And then I'm going to clean the image up, get rid of all of the distractions, all of these little tiny dots, and especially the house on the right side of the frame and the reflection of the house. Whenever you're erasing something from your image, always erase the shadow and the reflection that, you know, accompanies that. And this is where I kind of cross the border between photography and image design. Once you start adding in or removing stuff from the frame, it's no longer photography. So I kind of understand that, and I don't know where the line between photography and imagery, digital imagery, actually starts. But for me, every time I change something, every time I make something look different than it really was, in a sense of actually removing stuff out, then that's basically image design. I wouldn't enter this image into a photography contest just because of that. So I'm cleaning up the image, and I want everything to be just about the colors, the contrast, those two subjects, so the castle and the little island, and that color contrast, the really warm sky and the really cold ground. Now I'm gonna play with the contrast a little bit more. I'm also going to do some dodging and burning, brightening up and dimming down some areas, and I want to make the water brighter. So I'm going to go to my camera raw filter. I'm going to use the gradient filter to kind of bring up just the luminosity of the water. I'm going to tone down the clarity, the textures, but I'm going to up the decays, so to kind of retain the details of the reflections and the colors. Now I'm kind of matching the brightness of the water to the brightness of the sky, but retaining the details in the water and softening those ripples out. So the next thing is to bring back that little island, and I'm going to put a radial filter on top of the island. I'm going to up the exposure. I'm also going to up the clarity to make it really pop, and then I'm just going to balance everything out with the DHAZE dial. And now this really works very well if you want to bring something, if you want something to pop out, brighten the subject up, but not really make it really bright. So with the DHAZE dial, you just tone in everything so that it fits. So now I have the primary subject, which is the castle right in the middle of that, or in the center of that spiral eye. And I have that little island, which is kind of the secondary subject. Now, as I was taking this photo, one thing that really popped into my eye was the fog that just formed over the lake. And because the sun went down, the temperature changed, and you know, the whole inversion, the surface of the lake became kind of foggy and misty. And it's not really visible in this frame, so I'm going to add this in. I'm going to show you how you can do this. But first, I need to play a little bit with the color. So I'm going to change that purplish, reddish tint of the sky to a little bit more orangey, and the blue shadowy area to a little bit toned down blue. Maybe just bring in some little greens and stuff into the frame to make it a little bit more vibrant. Now when this is all done, I need to bring that haze on top of the water. I'm going to use a curves adjustment brush. I'm just going to lift up the shadows, invert the mask, and then just brush in a little sliver of that effect just on top of the water, not over the island, because I want that island to pop out and be contrasted with that fog. And you can see it just makes such an enormous difference. And I think the image now really represents what I actually saw as I was there, which was basically this castle, this island, that mist, and the colors and the reflection. So now I have everything I want to have, and it's pretty much balanced the way I want it to be. The final touch is going to be the sharpening. I use the Smart Sharpen filter on almost all of my photos. And I'm going to add a vignette, which I'm going to use the Camera Raw filter again. I just love the feature in Lightroom, or the Camera Raw filter for vignetting, because you just have everything that you need. I'm just going to apply a little bit of that vignette, maybe add another radial filter to kind of brighten up the subject a little bit more. And that's it. I hope you guys like the new format of editing videos. I'm gonna try and do this twice a week, hopefully. Leave a comment in the comment section if you have any questions or suggestions, please, you know, in the comment section. Thanks for watching. Follow me on Instagram just as well if you guys haven't followed me already. I do the follow for follow thing anyway, so it's a win-win situation. Subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and I'll see you guys tomorrow.